Former Vice President Atiku Abubakar has accused President Bola Tinubu's administration of diverting public funds through undisclosed petrol subsidy payments. Atiku made this allegation in a statement on Thursday following the president's denial of reintroducing a petrol subsidy regime. Hi, welcome to What's Happening. These are the top 10 stories. At number 1, former Vice President Atiku Abubakar has accused President Bola Tinubu's administration of diverting public funds through undisclosed petrol subsidy payments. Atiku criticized the government's inconsistent statements regarding the subsidy and challenged the transparency of President Tinubu's administration. Meanwhile, Special Advisor to the President on Information and Strategy, Bayo Onanuga, issued a statement Thursday urging the public and media to disregard the leaked draft of the Accelerated Stabilization and Advancement Plan, ASAP, presented to President Bola Tinubu by the Minister of Finance, Wale Edun, on Tuesday, and cease further discussions. He reiterated that the era of petrol subsidy is gone for good. The ASAP estimated a fuel subsidy expenditure of 5.4 trillion naira for 2024, significantly higher than the 3.6 trillion naira spent in 2023. At number 2, Finance Minister Wale Edun has submitted various options for a new national minimum wage and their projected costs to President Bola Tinubu. Edun's report, delivered Thursday, includes several potential minimum wage levels and their expected fiscal impact on the federal budget. On June 3rd, organized labor proposed 615,500 naira and 494,000 naira as the new minimum wage, but the government deemed these figures unrealistic. On the same day, Tinubu committed to a national minimum wage higher than 60,000 naira as agreed upon in a meeting between the federal government and organized labor. Today, the tripartite committee comprising the federal government and labor unions resumed discussions on a new minimum wage for Nigerian workers. At number 3, Minister of Women Affairs Uju Kennedy Ohaneye has denied being under investigation for alleged fund misappropriation. Speaking on Newsnight, a television program, Kennedy Ohaneye clarified that she has not been invited by the House of Representatives regarding the matter. This response came after the chairman of the House Committee on Women Affairs and Social Development, Kafila Tobara, claimed that two committees in the lower chamber were investigating her. The minister refuted these claims, explaining that committees invited her office, not her personally. She criticized Obara for making public statements about the investigation, asserting that the discrepancies noted were related to financial reports and constituency projects, not her actions. Despite the allegations, the minister reiterated her commitment to addressing women's issues and expressed her willingness to cooperate with the House if officially called upon. At number 4, the House of Representatives has resolved to investigate the alleged fraudulent allocation of title documents to some real estate developers before Yesim Wike's appointment as Minister of the Federal Capital Territory, FCT. The resolution followed the motion of urgent public importance moved by Honorable Jonathan Bethwe, representing Nasarawa, during Thursday plenary session. Bethwe noted that prior to Wike's appointment, several title land documents in the FCT were issued to real estate developers under suspicious circumstances. Bethwe questioned the legality of Director of Land or other officials of the Federal Capital Territory Administration, FCTA, or Federal Capital Development Authority, FCDA, issuing the right of occupancy in the minister's name during a period when the minister's office was vacant. The House also urged Minister Wike to withdraw land allocations that are subject to litigation or multiple allocations until the issue is resolved. At number 5, the National Association of Nigerian Students and the Niger Delta Youth Leaders Front have called for an autopsy report on Jeffrey Chamoke Ekron, a mechanical engineering student at Ajayi Crowther University, who was allegedly beaten to death by his colleagues over a phone theft accusation. Akoran and Ishakiri Prince from Warri Delta State resided in Shefford Inn Hostel on the university's premises and was reportedly tortured from 6 p.m. on Friday until about 10 a.m. on Saturday. 25 students aged 18 to 34 have been arraigned in the Chief Magistrate Court in Oyo State and remanded in a custodial center until July 8th, pending trial. The leadership of NANS visited the university, protesting and demanding an autopsy to identify the real culprits involved in Akron's murder. Comrade Lucky Emonefe, NANS Universal President, and Honorable Chukwutem Nwogwo, President of the Niger Delta Youth Leaders Front, while speaking to journalists, expressed doubts about the identity of the 25 suspects and accused security agents and the school management of shielding the true perpetrators. At number 6, the federal government has commenced the trial of two executives from Telkom Satellites Limited, TSTV, over allegations of tax evasion, money laundering and advanced fee fraud. Dr. Bright Ikechukwu Echefu, Managing Director and CEO of TSTV, and Dr. Felix Namdi Iguanuga, Executive Director of the company, are being tried along TSTV and Bridgeburg Investments Limited. The trial, held at the Federal High Court in Abuja, involves 9 criminal charges brought by the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission, EFCC. Echefu and Inanuga are accused of diverting 33.9 million naira, 13.5 million naira, and 19.4 million naira intended for the federal government to their personal use. Both accused individuals pleaded not guilty to the charges. The prosecution, led by Sylvanus Tahir San, opposed the bail application presented by Eyitayo Fatogun San, citing the defendants as flight risks. However, Justice Iyang Edem Ekwo adopted the EFCC's administrative bail conditions, allowing the defendants to remain free with restrictions, including a travel ban without court permission and the seizure of their passports. The trial is set to commence on July 15th, 16th and 17th. At number 7, Bauchi State Governor Bala Mohammed has dismissed the caretaker chairman of Al-Kaliri local government area, Bala Mahmood, and his deputy with immediate effect. The announcement was made in a letter signed by Secretary to the State Government, Ibrahim Kashim, stating that the dismissal was approved by Governor Bala Abdul Kadir Mohammed. The reasons for the dismissal were not disclosed at the time of this report. Kashim directed the Permanent Secretary of the Ministry for Local Government and Chieftaincy Affairs to ensure that the dismissed officers hand over their duties to the head of administration. At number 8, the National Drug Law Enforcement Agency, NDLEA, has arrested several intending pilgrims to Saudi Arabia after uncovering cocaine consignments in their possession. During a raid on Emerald Hotel in the Ladipo area of Oshodi Lagos State, NDLEA operatives apprehended Usman Kamuruddin, Ola Sunkami Owolabi, Fatai Yekini, and Ayinla Kemi as they prepared to ingest cocaine wraps ahead of their flight to the ongoing Hajj. The raid, which took place on Wednesday, June 5, 2024, was part of an intelligence-led operation. In a statement released on Thursday, Femi Babafemi, NDLEA's Director of Media and Advocacy, revealed that the 4 suspects were lodged in 2 rooms where they had prepared 200 pellets of cocaine weighing 2.20 kilograms. The NDLEA officers recovered 100 wraps of cocaine from each room, intended for 2 suspects to swallow 100 wraps each. retired Brigadier General Mohamed Buba Marwa, chairman and CEO of the NDLEA, mentioned that the agency would collaborate with counterparts in Saudi Arabia to trace and prosecute the designated recipients of seized drug consignments in the country. At number 9, Bugesera Football Club striker Elijah Ane is a contender for the inaugural Rwanda Premier League Player of the Year award, Daily Post reports. Ane, a Nigerian national, was the top scorer in the Rwandan top flight during the 2023/2024 season, netting 15 goals in 27 league matches. His impressive performance was pivotal in helping Bugesera Football Club avoid relegation and reach the final of the Peace Cup, although they lost to the Police Football Club. Competing alongside Ane for the prestigious award are APR's Jim Busco, Rubenika, and Rayon Sports star Kevin Muhir. The award ceremony is scheduled to take place at the Serena Hotel in Kigali on Saturday, June 15th. Finally, at number 10, the recent floods in Bavaria, Germany have affected the European Parliament elections, leading to the relocation of several polling stations and reports of lost voting documents. Thomas Gossel, Bavaria's state election officer, stated that some town halls in affected regions were not yet usable, prompting the establishment of provisional municipal administrations. Despite these challenges, Gossel expressed confidence that the election could be conducted properly after discussions with election officers in the affected areas. He also noted that voters who have lost their voting documents or have not received them due to the flood are advised to promptly contact their local authority to request and collect new documents. Gossel added that new voting cards can still be used in Bavaria until noon on Saturday, ensuring that affected voters can participate in the elections. That's it and what's happening. You can join the conversation on our website at www.rootstv.ng, follow us on social media, and subscribe to our YouTube channel at Roots TV Nigeria. Thank you for watching.